August 7th, our fourth named system over the Atlantic Basin today. That's subtropical storm Debbie. Here's the latest stats on that system. Winds of 40 miles per hour, moving north at 16. And we're looking at this system again, floating around in the open waters of the Atlantic. No concern for threats to land or to areas around the United States. A system that's very unhealthy at this time, and again, subtropical storm status. So we're looking at winds at around 40 miles per hour. 39 miles per hour would have been a depression. This system doesn't have a long time to live. It's about 1160 miles to the west of the Azores, and a short-lived time span for this system because it's going to be on its way into cooler waters in the northern Atlantic. Here's the latest forecast ensemble of models, and again, pulling to the north and then eventually to the northeast. The official track from the National Hurricane Center showing winds potentially of 40 miles per hour into the afternoon and overnight, still holding on potentially to winds of 40 miles per hour early Wednesday before beginning its transition. We do expect the system to dissipate actually within the next 48 hours, if not before. So again, no threat to land, but our newest named system. I mentioned some cooler waters, and here's the outlook right now. The current temperatures around Debbie are around 75 to 79 degrees. 59 degree waters waiting just to the north of that system. So again, that's going to help to cut off that potential for the system to survive. Across the west of the Atlantic, we're watching also some waves marching across the monsoon trough and intertropical convergence zone. Not of concern for development. Lots of drier air out here over the Atlantic waters as well, and that's helping to curb that potential for tropical development. Over the Caribbean Sea, a few waves out here. Again, nothing of concern. High pressure to the north, and also this area of low pressure allowing winds to pick up closer to Panama. So gale force winds possible there, but again, no tropical concerns. Also some moisture building around the Gulf of Mexico with that Bermuda high helping to usher in some of that moisture over the Gulf. And so seeing more rainfall developing down around the Bay of Campeche. One little trough here hanging out, but again, not looking at concerns for development. As we roll into August, we watch those potential areas of formation increase. Most likely potential formation hanging out around the Leeward Islands closer to Cuba. And if certainly we have that chance of more likely development over the Gulf of Mexico, through the Caribbean, and around the western Atlantic because of the Gulf Stream. So that warmth would also help to spark off a few systems to develop. But not a whole lot happening right now. Debbie, again, the fourth named system of the season so far. Ernesto is the next name up on the list. The tropics overall, though, we're watching the peak, which moves in September 10th officially. That's climatologically speaking, before we drop off into the end of the season, which is November 30th. So a long ways to go, so you need to stay prepared. In the meantime, while we have a quieter setup over the Atlantic Basin, the Pacific is very busy with Hector, Christy, John, and Ileana all pretty much in a row lined up. And we're seeing those impacts in the open waters. Potentially some indirect impacts around Hawaii with Hector as it continues moving west, weakening gradually initially on Wednesday and then picking back up some steam into Friday and Saturday as potentially a Category 3 yet again. High seas and high surf likely around the Hawaiian Islands. That's your latest outlook on the tropics. Thanks for joining us here online at WDSU.com.